Hey guys, welcome to my channel Coding 24x7. My name is Harshit and this is the fifth lecture in the series of Python programming. So without wasting any time, let's dive into today's agenda. In this particular session, I will discuss Anaconda, Jupyter Notebook and Google Colab. So first of all, let's see what is Anaconda. So Anaconda is a free and open source distribution of Python and R programming language. It is widely used for machine learning, data science, etc. Now let's see how to install it in Windows 10 operating system. To download Anaconda, just open web browser and type Anaconda download. So I'm just typing Anaconda download. All right. So now you can see the very first link, individual edition Anaconda. You have to just click on it. Now click on products and select individual edition. So guys, we are already on the individual edition page. To download, scroll a bit and you can find download tab. Here it is. Now click on it. So now you can see here there are three platforms available to download Anaconda. So I will go with Windows 64-bit graphical installer. Click on it. All right, you can see download has been started, but I will pause because I have already downloaded it. Okay, now minimize the browser. So you can see here it is on the desktop. Now you double click on it. Click on next. Click on agree. Okay, let it selected for just me. Click on next. So guys, I am not going to click on it because Anaconda is already installed into my system. Now for your better understanding, let me take you to the Anaconda documentation. Now click on Anaconda documentation. Then click on Anaconda individual edition. Now click on installation. To see installation on Windows, you need to click here. So guys, you can see here, this is the next step from where I have aborted the installation of Anaconda. Now you can see there are two options. So you can select the first checkbox if you want to add Anaconda to path environment. If you don't know how to set path, you can refer to my lecture 2. I will also provide the link in the description. After clicking on install, you will see this screen. That means Anaconda is successfully installed. Now let's understand what is Jupyter Notebook. So Jupyter Notebook is a web-based interface to write Python code and also to visualize the output in the form of graphs and charts. Guys, you need not to install Jupyter Notebook separately because it already comes with Anaconda distribution. To open Jupyter, all you need is to type Anaconda prompt in the search bar. Click on here. Now type Jupyter Notebook. All right, you can see Jupyter Notebook is opened in the web browser. So guys, today I will not discuss Jupyter Notebook in detail. Now let me quickly introduce you to Google Colab. So guys, if you don't have Python installed into your system, you can still run your Python code. That is the beauty of Google Colab, because it connects you to the Python interpreter remotely through internet. Let's see how to use Google Colab. To open it, you need to open your Gmail account. So here I have already opened my Gmail account. Now click on Drive. So I have already opened my drive. Here you can see. Now click on My Drive. Then click on More. And you can see here Google Collaboratory. Now click on it. So I have already opened it, Google Collaboratory. You can see here. You need to click on Connect to Hosted Runtime to remotely connect with Python Interpreter. Now you are ready to write your Python code. Now let me show you a simple addition. So let me add 5 plus 7. To run this file, you need to click here. Alright, so it's working fine. So guys, this is all for the today's session. In the next lecture, we will see Jupyter Notebook in detail. Thank you.